Magician's time, baby! It's been a while since I updated the Pyramid Magicians, and this video I'm going to showcase to you guys my take on Pyramid Magicians that ends on an unbreakable board and just obliterates decks going second with the most insane side decks. So you guys ready for this video? Make sure to smash the subscribe button. We're almost at 40,000 subscribers. And don't forget to sign up on Patreon, because from now on, every single YouTube video that I post will have a supplemental video on Patreon with duels on the deck, with more knowledge for you guys to learn Pendulum Magicians even more. So you guys ready for this video? Smash the subscribe button and let's go! It's Pendulum Magicians time! Magicians. This video, I'm going to showcase you guys a combo tutorial, a new and improved combo tutorial, a little bit different from the last one I posted about pure Pendulum Magicians, that is just a way better combo and is a big improvement on when we first built the deck. If you guys remember, in the first version we had of Pendulum Magicians, it did not include Dark Worm. I think that's an absolute shame not to include Dark Worm in a deck with Pendulum Call. So we absolutely need to play it. So it's still the whole idea around one Needle Fiber is going to end on Scythe with a bunch of interruptions, but this time the interruptions are better. I don't know if you guys remembered, when I originally did this combo, it was with Cyber Disintegrator and Coral Dragon, allowing you to draw two cards. Well, ending on a Herald just helps you guys a lot more and ends on more negates to ensure the Scythe's going to resolve. So I updated this combo to make it even better with more information that I've learned about the deck. So up next, we're gonna get a search here. One cool thing to note, by the way, is that if you really want to, you can use a Tuning Magician to special summon it to the field, and then the effect to trigger for the damage 400 damage will trigger Dagda to set your Scythe, but there's no reason to waste your level one at the moment right there. So here, I'm gonna also do a little different of a build. This build, I'm gonna showcase a version that utilizes Absolute and Vortex. I personally I don't think it's the best version, but you could definitely play a version with Absolute and Vortex, which will result in a crazier board. In my honest opinion, one Scythe with one Herald is auto win instantly, and then I'd rather just save as many possible cards in my hand to OTK the next turn. But this is going to be another cool combo I'm going to showcase you guys here first. Dagda will trigger on Harmonizing's effect. Here we're going to go into Tornado Dragon, and then with those two, we're going to go into Selene. Selene is going to special the Tuning Magician. Tuning Magician and the Oath Dragon is going to go into Meteor Burst, which is a combo, a card that I did not use in my last combo tutorial at all, which will summon out Dragon Pit, that will summon out Cross Sheep to bring out Vortex. So I think this is extremely cool that you could do this. Cross Sheep summon out that, go Selene. Selene will then special out the Dragon Pit. And at this situation, I go Unique. Typically, I can go Appaloosa, but I don't have access to the Pendulum Graph. So I'm going to summon out a Union Carrier in this situation if I wanted to, but I opted, you know what, I don't really need the Pendulum Graph. So what I'm going to do instead here is I'm going to put Chronograph in the Time Gazer. I'm going to summon out a Tuning Magician, because I now have two Magicians in my scales, but because I did not activate Tuning Magician's effect yet. And then what I'm going to do is then I'm going to go Carrier with the two of them. And I'm going to save my Selene to summon out something on the opponent's turn. And then I'm going to leave it at this. I'm going to then pop the Double Iris with Tornado to get a Pendulum Graph. I'm going to have Open Tide Gazer to pop as well. On the opponent's turn, I'm going to Tornado pop the Scythe. And look at that, just like that. I have a Herald, I have a Vortex, I have a Scythe, Tornado. It's too good. This is just an auto win. This is straight up an auto win. You have Pendulum Graph as well. Your opponent cannot go into the extra deck whatsoever. And you just auto win. On your turn, you Selene Access Code them for game. This is the new and improved way to play Pendulum Magicians. Pure Pendulum Magicians. Now I'm going to showcase you guys the deck profile, but this deck profile will not be using the Vortex. If you guys love this idea of Pure Magicians, make sure to check out my Patreon. I just posted duels with this exact deck, dueling against a lot of the meta, so go check it out right now. And if you guys want to sign up as well on the Patreon, if you guys haven't signed up already, Patreon's actually offering 15% off. I think it's a limited time only for the entire year, so it's a pretty great deal if you guys want to check it out. So with that being said, let's go check out now the deck profile. This is the deck profile. Similar ideas before. You need triple harmonizing and triple tuning is absolutely mandatory. There's actually, if you guys notice, there's no Magician Souls in this version. I made it as budget as humanly possible. I'm very aware that Revolution Dragon is a little expensive, not a lot, but it's not like $100 like Magician Souls. I'm aware Fiber and Linkross are a little bit expensive, but it's not $100 like Magician Souls. So I try to make it as cheap as possible, but still as good as possible. If you guys want to cut it to 40, you can make it 2 Revolution Dragons if you want to. It's like, it's great to open Dark Worm. It's not mandatory, but it's great to open. In terms of extenders, it has less extenders than before, because for one, you don't need to open an extender to play. A lot of the best plays actually for this deck is to Pendulum Summon first and save your normal summon from Oaf Dragon adding back. That's why we added Oaf Dragon to 3. Oaf is probably the best, one of the best magicians here. You guys don't understand is that it not only gives you a low scale, but it's a +1 every single turn. And when you special it, it gets back Revolution Dragon to get another Dark Orb, or it could get back any of these. But typically, you'll have a Revolution Dragon in the graveyard because it was sent there for Dark Worm. So, Oaf Dragon is extremely powerful in this build. And in this build, you only have 3 extenders in Chronograph and the Pen Call Dark Worm extender. And you have Tuning Magician extender as well. So, you have 6 guaranteed extenders with like 6 more pseudo extenders. So, if you actually 5 more, because you cut Revolution Dragon to 2. So, if you don't open one of your 11 extenders, you don't need to. Just Pen Summon. You have the best extender in the game called Pendulum Summoning. You don't always need to do it before your Pen Summon. That's why I tick out the combo where you draw 3 times. Because sometimes when you don't have that great of a hand, you have to make your combo with Harmonize. Like, Harmonizing Magician has to be your tuner after your Pen Summon. And that's totally cool. You know, it's not mandatory to do it before your Pen Summon. That's why it's like really cool the way I built this extra deck. A lot more space as well. I don't think you need Dark Rebellion, but if you're on a budget, you could put in Dark Rebellion for the Axis Code Talker. You can also take out the Savage Dragon for like an Omega or like the Synchro 8 Tenyi or whatever that one's called. They're all good. There's lots of budget alternatives to this deck. I would also recommend playing Triple Desires. Going second is also extremely important with this deck. A lot of the testing, I take out Desires in case I banish the Duelist and Lions cards or the Double Iris, but who cares? Double Iris, like, it's okay. Like, Double Iris is fantastic to have in this deck, but if it's banished, it's banished. If you banish Scythe, it's banished. Big deal. You still put out a bunch of negates, and it's mandatory for going second, and you need to open one spell. So you have 13 spell cards here. You need to open one. If you open one of your 13 spell cards, then you could Selene Special Attuning, which gives you one free monster. Triple Wisdom, triple Oaf, one Celestia, one Double Iris, one Poison. These are all the correct numbers. Oaf and Wisdom are way too important. I understand you're playing Pen Call, but it doesn't matter. You need to open Pen Call or Wisdom. It's just not a it's not an option. It's just not an option. You need to open Pen Call, Wisdom, or Duelist Alliance, and it helps you so much. Like, the value you get off one of them is huge. Also, if you Pen Call, you could still Double Iris via Union Carrier. That's why I think it's very cool to play now. Triple Corona, the Double Revel, Triple Dark Worm, 1-0. If you guys don't care about money, I would play one Magician Souls. If you really, I would try to make this as budget as humanly possible. If you don't care about money, I'd play one Magician Souls. You could play 3 if you want, but the deck just doesn't, the way we built it, doesn't need too many extenders. One is great to search off Time Star, but a lot of the time when you're searching off Time Star, Herald's already on the field, so it's not absolutely mandatory. And not many times you're gonna want to send one of these. Sending a Star Pendulum Graph does not give you a plus exactly. You're just plusing for that, like, you just get one free card for that one turn, but that one card that you drew, you're gonna get back next turn anyways, because Star Pendulum Graph adds you a Magician every single turn. And then Triple Pen Call, Triple Alliance does not break. If you don't open a Pen Call, usually just for Pen Call specific reasoning, and Duelist Alliance will typically search you Double Iris or any of the Pendulum Graphs is usually the better call, because Spell Pendulum Graph is broken. It'll be able to add you a free Magician every turn. So typically, when you normal, if let's say you open, for example, Chronograph and Harmonizing. So you summon out Time Gazer, or even if you have Dark Worm, summon out Time Gazer, normal Dark Worm, activate Pendulum Graph, you get a free gate 0, and then Pendulum Graph, get a free Harmonizer, and then you make your free Needle Fiber combo. Side deck, triple Sphere, triple Lava Golem. It's fine. Like I said, you don't need, I built the deck for that reason. With the side deck, literally has Sphere Mode and Lava Golem. So I don't want the main deck combo to be based on normal summoning. I just don't want it. So I made sure to put those in. So that's why I built the main deck like that, where in the sense that I don't need the normal summon. You just Pendulum Summon and then do your combo. And that's the beauty of Harmonizing, of the Sphere Mode and Lava Golem. Dark Ruler as well. These 9 are the best 9 cards to side deck right now. Any deck that doesn't really require a normal summon. Double Mystic Mind and a Dino Wrestler. So I'm playing these. You're playing these 12 against combo decks. If you open any of the 2 of these 12, you auto win any combo deck, even Inferno Bowl. I don't care if Inferno Bowl has Smoke Grenade. You have 12 cards that auto destroy the whole board. Just draw 2 of them. You have a bunch of draw cards and you're playing 12. Lastly, one Bloodlust, one Reboot, and one Dead Rush are these three for background decks. I'll take out the Scythe against background decks. And against background decks, I'll take out anything that's like not extremely plus. Maybe like one Twinning Magician, one Scythe, and maybe one Oath. I don't know, but maybe something like that. Because going second against background, like Purple Poison a lot. And one Dark Rebellion, because going second, you take out the Scythe combo typically, so you just have a free card to put in your extra deck. And going second, this card just 5k damage for free. Extra deck, in order of the combo, is Needlefiber, Celine, Linkross, Formula Herald, Marcher Herald, Dagda, in order of the combo. And then you have Tornado to help pop the Scythe. And then you have Time Star, which helps out for certain situations to get free pluses. And a lot of the times, it's just a free plus. In fact, I would recommend playing the one Magician Soul. It could help when times when you brick. The one might be able to help you. Even pull side deck when you might have too many side cards. One Savage is nice. One Carrier, one Selene, one Appaloosa, and then one Selene, one Access Code. Typically, there is three Selenes for a reason. Typically, you use both Selenes on turn one. But that's why you want to make sure on turn two, you have another Selene for the Access Code. That's the video. I hope you guys enjoy it. If you guys got this far, don't forget to smash the subscribe button. And if you guys love Pendulum, check out the Patreon where I'm going to showcase you guys duels with this deck. And if you guys want to learn more about Pendulums, I just now offer a Pendulum coaching. Just send $20 to PayPal, $30 to PayPal USD, and that offers 2 hours of coaching for $30, one-on-one coaching, me and you, on Discord. Also, now the trip game playmats are just the one of them are $30 USD, the triple entrant playmat. Get it before it's sold out. It's a limited time offer, very special. And if you guys want any discounts, get them right now. I'll help you guys out. Get yourself all the discounts down below on Yu-Gi-Oh! Products and playmats. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Peace!